Journey into STEM and Finding Academic Voice, an Autistic Researcher's Insight. Hello everyone, my name is Laura Gilmore and I'm a PhD candidate at the University of Alberta in Canada and an Autistic Self-Advocate. Today I'm going to delve a little bit about my journey into STEM while also making you think a bit about the definition of STEM and some options that combine STEM with other disciplines such as the arts. Early years. Early on, I wanted to be a vet. You can see me in that picture in early university was a collection of my pets. I loved animals since early childhood and saw in the 7th grade yearbook was messages about neutering cats to prevent pet overpopulation. However, by high school, I began to have an interest in helping others with disabilities and realized my poor fine motor skills were not a good match for veterinary medicine. For instance, I struggled to assemble lab equipment in high school chemistry and required a lot of assistance from lab partners and teachers, despite understanding the concepts. I entered university knowing I needed a few accommodations, such as a computer for typing short answer questions or essays, and an assistant for assembling lab equipment. I excelled more in STEM courses that did not involve math or work which required a high degree of motor skills such as assembling machinery. For instance, I took great joy in science psychology courses such as neuropsychology or perception. A few of my psychology instructors noted my strengths in psychology courses and with research ideas and asked if I would consider going to graduate school, but I was still undecided. Hurdles along the way. It wasn't all an easy ride. I entered education with the hope of being a special education teacher after 2 years of Bachelor of Arts. Despite an overall good GPA, my difficulties with moving about in space while facial recognition and recognizing body language made it so teaching in a classroom of children wasn't the best option. In addition, I realized my math abilities had a ceiling and a straight science degree wasn't the right path. At one point, I reduced my academic course load to part-time due to stress level, and as a student with disability, I was still considered a full-time student if in at least one-third course load. In Alberta, I was allowed to pay tuition for the number of courses I was enrolled in, rather than having to pay tuition for a full-time course load. However, this likely varies from region to region and country to country. In all, I made 3 program switches for various reasons, including my need to find just the right academic supervisor who would understand my unique needs once I decided research was the route I wanted. Finding a supervisory match. In fall of 2008, I approached psychology professor Dr. Malika Shalaman, who always encouraged me as a student, and asked if she had any research opportunities available. We were able to combine her expertise in neuroscience and sexuality with my research interest in autism to create an online survey on sexuality and autism. She was a supportive mentor who challenged my thinking and had high expectations, but also set boundaries as needed. For instance, if I was in her class and dominated a class discussion, she would speak to me discreetly. I also benefited as a student from her direct say-it-like-it-is feedback as a literal thinking. She is still an academic colleague and an important influence, as well as in recent years, a friend who is further along in her academic journey who I can ask for advice. She is pictured beside me at my bachelor's graduation, and she also attended my master's graduation as a guest, and hope to see her at my PhD graduation. Emerging researcher. I was not an official honors student due to having a reduced course load, but I conducted an honors equivalent study and took honors courses. I also had my first experience with data collection when I spent the summer of 2009 recruiting survey participants online and realizing I had a strength for the use of social media and online engagement in data collection. Our article was published in a top autism journal, Research in Autism Spectrum Disorders, right before graduation, and also involved collaboration of my current research supervisor, Dr. Veronica Smith, on the project. Dr. Shalaman, my undergraduate supervisor, wrapped the published article up like a gift and handed it to me on my bachelor's graduation and said it was a graduation present. It took me 7 years to do a bachelor's degree, but I got there and graduated with distinction, A minus average, despite a couple of seasoned math courses and a handful of withdrawal without academic penalty from courses and situations that weren't a good match for me. Transition to flying solo. One big difference I've noticed with graduate school, and it has been a big step for me, is that my supervisor, Dr. Veronica Smith, after guarding me for the first few years, began to tell me I needed to decide on my own how to design a methodology or choose a measure, and that I had to be effective at communicating that back to her and my committee in writing. Theory of mind is sometimes a barrier for me in writing when dealing with a new methodology. I sometimes assume things which are in my head are common knowledge to everyone, and the process sometimes becomes tricky. Even in undergraduate, I chose my research questions, but there was a lot more guidance on developing methodology and data analysis. I had Dr. Smith in my master's, and in my master's there was somewhat more support, but the doctoral program is really different in that they encourage you to be even more independent. Doing things on my own and making decisions was terrifying at first, and sometimes I made bad choices at first and would have to be steered back in the right direction. I'm still getting there, but will be ready when I graduate to do research on my own. Finding my academic voice. Even though I think my supervisors are both highly intelligent academics and excellent researchers, the voice that has emerged in my work in the last year has been my own, even if influenced some by the teachings and ideals I learned from both my supervisors. Much like adult children form worldviews separate from their parents, I develop views on autism from the literature I read, interactions with my own autism community, and academic conferences I selected. And my emerging views somewhat challenge traditional ones, and my supervisor is open to this as long as I am able to justify my position and back it up with research. The cultural neurodiversity theory my PhD dissertation is based upon supports the idea that therapy for autistic individuals to teach communication and self-help skills and reduce harmful behaviors, for instance, aggression. However, autistics should not be forced to give up stimming or special interests or be somebody they're not. Concluding thoughts. The research I am involved in now is qualitative research. In the current project, I'm actually developing a children's book that creates an analogy that compares the experience of a child living with autism and learning social skills to the struggles of a new immigrant child as a way of letting people explore my theoretical concept of cultural neurodiversity in a school setting. Quantitative research deals with numbers, often cause and effect, whereas qualitative research looks at the lived human experience, which is more of a process, lived experience question. Sometimes they are combined to look at the same question in different ways, and this is mixed method research. The acronym STEM stands for science, technology, engineering, and math. However, there is a debate about whether social sciences should also be considered under science, and if A should be added to the acronym for arts-based methods to understand scientific conditions. Really, science is about asking questions, and some of these questions may be cause and effect, and some may be understanding the process. When starting a journey, you need to find a path that best suits your cognitive style, both in coursework and supervisors and instructors who you are able to work with well. Also, I know that you may change your mind a few times, and this is typical of all students, not just autistic ones. You will get there eventually. Bye for now.